We will solve Irodov problem 1.5. In this problem, we are given two particles who are initially at the locations given by position vector r1 and r2. They are having certain velocities, and their velocity, suppose it is in some direction. Now for the particles, in the problem we have been given that what should be the relationship between the velocity v1 vector, v2 vector, r1 vector and r2 vector such that the particles collide. This is particle 1 and this is 2. Now this is the initial position and this is the vector joining these two, and this will be r1 minus r2 vector. For the particles to collide, the direction has to be such that at least they meet at some point. It can be this, it can be this, it can be this. At least some meeting point has to happen. So let us take any arbitrary direction. Let this be like this. Let the directions of v1, v2 be such. This be direction of v1, this be direction of v2. Let them collide after time t. Collide after time t. So distance traveled by point 1, d1 will be v1t and d2 will be v2t. We can write in terms of vector like this. So this distance, this one is r1 minus r2 is this. r1 vector minus r2 vector is this. This will be v1t and this will be v2t vector. Now it's a simple problem. From vector method you can solve it and join the point like this. If you look at this triangle and this triangle, let us look at the velocity vector diagram. It is like this. This one is v1t in this direction. Distance v2t. V2t is like this. Let us write in terms of an opposing vector A, and this is vector B. If we draw it like this, what will be this vector, this direction? It will be vector A minus vector B. Same triangle, we have redrawn it. This is v1t, we have written A vector in this direction, B vector in this direction. A vector is minus v1t and B vector is minus v2t. Just direction are reversed. So this vector A minus vector B is equal to v2 vector t minus v1 vector t. These two are same. A minus B vector modulus is equal to r1 minus r2 modulus. So we can equate, we get relationship t times modulus v2 minus v1 vector is equal to modulus r1 vector minus r2 vector. We have taken modulus because this distance is same, common. So value of t is equal to r1 minus r2 modulus upon v2 minus v1 modulus. Now we can write this vector as sum of these two vectors. This is common again, and this is sum of these two vectors. Let this be vector P. So vector P is equal to r1 vector plus v1 vector t, and same p is equal to r2 vector plus v2 vector t. These are equal, so r1 vector plus p1 vector t is equal to r2 vector plus v2 vector t. So t is equal to r2 vector minus r1 vector upon v1 vector minus v2 vector. These are vectors. Equate these two. This was modulus here also. Equate these two, so you get modulus of r1 minus r2 upon modulus of v2 minus v1 is equal to r2 vector minus r1 vector upon v1 vector minus v2 vector. You can reverse it, minus plus minus plus. So it becomes r1 minus r2 vector upon modulus of r1 minus r2 is equal to v2 vector minus v1 vector upon modulus of v2 vector minus v1 vector. So this is the relationship between the four vectors so that the particle should collide.